second largest animal ever to have lived on the planet. In the western North Atlantic Ocean, they'll easily hit the mid-60-foot range when fully grown. Largest fin whale on record, measured in at just under 90 feet in length. Above.
His way in here, you can look either up ahead, off the bow, and to the right, or up ahead, off the bow, and to the left, your port side. Now take your pick. You should be able to look off either side here, at least initially. Watch for the tail off the port side. Alright, that whale off the port side just dove.
Look at that, huh?
Okay, these two off the starboard side are up. Actually, this one's about to dive here. That one's gone. Alright, so we'll see how long it takes this animal to come back up. So a little bit to the right. You see the water looks a little greenish up there? You see there's a ring of air bubbles coming up? So as Brian swings the boat around, you want to look ahead and to the right about 1 o'clock, starboard side. Right side of the boat, starboard side. There you go. And three people going to stern of the boat, look to the right as well. Oh wow, look at the rain, what looks like a raindrops on top of the water. Somebody earlier in the trip was asking about these whales are feeding on. You look beneath the surface of the water that's making that. Okay, there's his tail come back.
Still a good amount of whales here, huh? Where are we, Brian? Oh, Francisco.
See on top of the heads, old-time whalers used to refer to them as stone bolts. They're actually nothing more than enlarged hair follicles. Each one of them has one short, stiff, sensory hair, kind of like a cat's whisker or a dog's whisker. The pale greenish patches that you see in the water on each side of the whale, those are their flippers, basically the whale's arms.
Where they are,
only show us what's under us, not around us.
Oh, he's a kid.
Yeah.
Back off the port side. Back behind us. And look up ahead. Actually, see a lot of fish at the surface between us and these whales. Just ahead and to the left. As you look at this tight cluster that's spread between us and these two boats up ahead of us, humpback whales actually are a particularly good example of a species of whale that works well cooperatively. You're looking at off the port side of the boat, the vast majority of those right side of the boat, starboard side. Now, we're just to the right, about a boat right out, just behind us here. And just under the left or port side of the bow, so you can look again in either direction.
Yes, if they came straight in.
Although this bunch.
Actually,
we're just kind of sitting here drifting, but there's a couple of these whales right underneath us right now.
Here it comes. Here it comes, Chris. Hey.
Whoa! Wow. Actually, if anybody needs any really useless information the next time you're at a party, look at these two whales off the port side of the boat. The one on the right, that one, is left-handed. And if you look carefully at its head, you'll see that the whole left side of the head is all scarred up. Whales, like humans, that's the lefty right there. Whales, like humans, are predominantly right side oriented, but every now and then you'll find one that's lefty.
Oh, yeah.
You certainly have that off the port side. All right, watch for the tails again, port side.
Two over there, one over there.
All the time.
Yeah. I told you, 97. 97, it hit the pulpit right off.
Yeah.
By the people was.
Did you see that preacher, Mickey? Yep. Watch this. Yeah, that must be on a dolphin bit, huh? Wow. Gotcha, fellas. Guy's hang on now. I'm hanging on. That must have been a whale. Whoa. Yeah, that one. Can't go far. You got a bar right there. What's happening? Burning more fuel than anybody else.
Now, as you look at these three groups of whales that are right around us fairly close, well, the others off in the distance, too. The waters here off of eastern Massachusetts.
Hang on,
kids. The waters here off of eastern Massachusetts actually are about the southernmost feeding area for western North Atlantic humpbacks. I move.
One, two, three.
Right here at 2 o'clock, they're all coming up.
Waters here off of eastern Massachusetts.
Wow, look at that.
Two.
Two? Looks like he's got a call.
Actually, about the southernmost feeding area for humpbacks in the western
North. Oh, look at that. Waving.
Hey.
Anyway, the waters here off eastern Massachusetts actually about the southernmost feeding area for humpbacks in the western North Atlantic Ocean. Look at this whale on the starboard side. It's swimming upside down. Hell yeah. Okay, just rolled over again.
Yeah, now it's
one, two, three.
No, that's the same one right there.
No.
Oh, yeah, it's one underneath it again.
Yeah.
The water's here out of eastern Massachusetts, actually about the southernmost feeding area for western North of it. I curved northward from here, eventually as far as western Greenland. There's about a half a dozen major feeding areas for western North of it.
Enjoy the afternoon.
And you'll find humpbacks in these feeding areas pretty much throughout, or call it the summer half of the year. Later on in the autumn,
You notice the white on the dorsal fin, it's not solid, it's kind of stippled. You look at the underside of the tail, you look carefully, that black and white is kind of stippled as well. But for any of you who just got a good look at the underside of that whale's tail, either through a pair of binoculars or a long camera lens, you'll notice that there's a set of straight black lines there that also look sort of stippled. But those are actually teeth marks from killer whales. So, left side of the boat, port side.
Oh! Sally, did you get that? Left, Sally, get it.
Left side, the port side.
How I know him.
Right side, starboard side.
Anyways, the other thing you want to take a look at is the underside of the tail. Some of them will be entirely white, some of them are entirely black. Most of them are going to be somewhere in between, with both the percentage of black and white varying as well as the pattern that black and white takes on, also varying. It's a group of at least six options. Now, I get that those things can sound like picky little details to be talking about. You know, there, look at those three dorsal fins there. Look at them all. You get a good amount of variability there. Subtle, yeah, but you get a good amount of variability. So yeah, subtle, but... Tail shots are hard to get, and you see these whales the whole time they're swimming, they're kind of circling around. They're not really thinking about it, they're not really going anywhere, they're just kind of back and forth through the same area. Another bubble cloud a little further out. Straight off the bat. So anyways, the dorsal fins, the coloring on the underside of the tails, subtle, but yeah, a lot of variability. Why do we care? Well, in the long run, those subtleties are the way that we tell one individual from another. And in the what do we get out of that? Well, you'd be surprised what we get out of that. We now know the same individuals return here year after year. We've got some individuals that we've looked at here pretty much almost every year for the last 40 years in a row. We've got a bunch of them that we've seen as many as 39 out of the last 40 years. Watch for the tails again. Or not. That's a big group off the port side, diving. You move northward from here, eventually as far as western Greenland. Every one of those other feeding areas, same individuals, albeit different sets of individuals. Returning to those feeding areas. That's how we know that the individuals that we find here in the summer months, or any of those other feeding areas in the summer months, are the individuals that are mixing together in the shallow reef areas north of the Dominican Republic and Puerto Rico for their winter mating and calving seasons. That's how we know they can swim between the Dominican Republic and here in as little as 5 weeks, about 1,700 miles. But somewhere off the coast of Antarctica will make it all the way north to western Costa Rica for their winter mating and calving season, fall and spring, all the way back to Antarctica to go. There's other ways you can recognize them. That one, actually two ways. One of which is that one whale laying at the top, you see, yeah, it's hard to see from this angle. Big, long, long set of propeller scars across the right side of its back. That one right there with its tail out of the water right now. Okay, that whale's got a big set of propeller scars on its right side. A minute ago, you heard one of them that clearly has a respiratory problem. We've got some 3,000 of these humpbacks that we've identified as individuals here in the last 40 years. There is one of them that has that respiratory problem, a female named Dolphin. She's had, quote me on the number, 10 calves so far that we know of. Hard to say for sure. We got 3,000 of them in the catalog, so it's hard for me to pull that kind of info out of my head on the individual, but...
bird watchers on the top deck, for any down in the lower deck as well. Try to get a look at all these sooty shearwaters. You see any others flying around? That shearwater there sitting in the middle of that slick area where those whales just were, the one that keeps sticking its head in the water. That's a greater shearwater. Those are the two dominant ones that I'm seeing around here right now. That whale that just dove off the starboard side also has teeth marks from killer whales on its tail.
Nice look at the inside of that.
actually an immature hairy dolphin sitting on top of that whale.
Walpole, right?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I know Walpole.
What's your last name?
Conway.
Conway.
All right, let's start this out. Actually, earlier I sort of misspoke. I said all of these animals aim down toward the Caribbean for their winter mating and calving season. They don't literally all go down there. They're juveniles. They don't actually go down there. They're certainly juveniles, certainly leave the highlands of North Carolina, Virginia, the Carolinas. Couple of reasons. First off, there's not really any food down in the Caribbean for them. We talked about that earlier. And it's the juvenile years when most of the growth occurs. But the other thing is, if they're juveniles, at the risk of stating the obvious, they're not involved in any mating or reproductive activity. So, eliminating the food aspect and eliminating the sex aspect and a lot of the motivation to swim 1,700 miles disappears really quickly.
Straight off the port side of the boat.
Hi, Andrews. This is for you. We love you. Have you chased the Chelsea?
Double mount for approach. Why would the Confederacy be interested in this odd little tourist town?
Who's getting their feet?
I was looked into the harbor for years.
You guys like the trip, good?
We had a wonderful time.
Hundreds of commercial fishing is where the entire planet. Third in line behind, I want to say, Acapulco and Sao Paulo. There's better than, there's 60 feet of water, almost all the way up to that breakwater.
Out here on warm surf, there was lines of houses. There was a lot of food processing went on out there. There was a lot
about hunting fin whales, we looked at one of them early on, or humpback whales, simply because they couldn't catch up with them.
Bye. Great trip.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.